Hi everybody, you are watching Vitorials. My name is Alex and today we're gonna talk about top 5 features of the new version of Gravit Designer. Versions 3.2 are now available for you and you can download it following the first link on the description. So let's start with the symbols. Symbols are reusable elements that you can use across all of your documents over and over again, and it helps you to be more proficient, more productive, and it helps you to create a consistent look and cohesive design. So, first, select your artwork and navigate to the symbols tab. As you can see, tutorials are now migrated under the help menu item, and under the symbols tab, click on this button on top right, this plus button to create new symbols. Click OK, and now you can issue as many instances, as many replicas as you want. Just simply drag and drop or use Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V or Command-C, Command-V on your Mac. All these guys called symbols instances, and you can modify pretty much every single aspect of your symbol instance. For example, let me show you. You can modify the color, you can add the effects and so on and so forth, and this does not affect another instances and does not affect the master symbol. And now you can go to the layer and navigate to the shape that you previously modified. Click on this button to reset the instance, and this resets all the changes you do to this shape. I'm going to create a full review of symbols in Gravit Designer in the near future, so make sure to subscribe to my channel or read this brilliant article written by Pablo Petson about symbols and anchoring here inside Gravit Designer. So let's go to the next feature. Next feature is Swatches. Swatches were available for you in the previous version of Gravit Designer, but now you can create and save your own Swatches panel. And I'm gonna actually import one of them. Let's say this 4. This is a 4-color Swatches panel. And you can, let's get rid of some of this, just simply dragging it out. And you now can export, name you as you wish. And voila, you create your Swatches panel. Let me show you if it works. XYZ. It's working like a charm. So now you can create your favorite color palettes and use them again and again, because consistency is the key, right? Let's go to the next feature, and next feature is icons. You now have it on the library tab. You have a shapes, illustration, icons, images, stickers, frames and lines all available for you from well-established icon 8 icon foundry right here inside Gravit Designer. This tremendously boosts workflow and increase productivity, and as always you can read about icons in the upcoming Gravit Designer article, so make sure to subscribe to Gravit Designer Medium blog. So let's go to the next feature. Next feature is Canvas. By Canvas I mean of course page. It's called page in Gravit Designer, and if you go to the page settings you would notice these two new icons. First is Rotate Canvas. It can allows you to change the orientation from landscape to portrait and vice versa. And second is the Trim Canvas. Trim Canvas trim your canvas to the size of contained elements. It's something like trim transparent pixels inside Adobe Photoshop or fit to artwork bonds inside Adobe Illustrator. So let's go to the next feature. It's our last, but not least, of course. It's mask with the shape. Now you can, I think, mask in more convenient way that was previously with the clip option. You can actually move the shape above your image, above your photo, above your design. Then select them both and Control Shift M or Command Shift N on your Mac. I believe it Command Shift N on your Mac, and or use your right mouse button key and just go with mask with the shape. So this is basically the end of this video. If you enjoyed it, give a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. And if you want to learn about every single update inside Gravit Designer, make sure to check this brilliant article written by Christian Kramer about every single improvement in Gravit Designer. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to visit vitorials.net for more Gravit Designer tutorials. And have a nice day!